bring donations from everyone from around the world from our GoFundMe and stuff. Cut to Pan of the Billion. But in the meantime, we wanted to put out a video on variations on this drill that we saw online. It's actually a football drill.
Yeah.
But we saw so many kata movements in there that we thought it would be cool to just show. So explain the drill first, and we'll see if we can branch off with different ideas.
Yeah, so you'll forgive me if I forget the nomenclature. It's like a shucking drill or a shove or a shiv or I don't remember what they, whatever that is called. But basically it's it's this from the, if you're like a lineman, defensive lineman or something, if you're at 3 point, it's the pop to that swim, not swim, but that shove. And so we got a lot of these framing movements in a lot of the katas that we do, right? This movement, that shutouke, or even this thing is very similar, right? So coming from here, shove, you're basically creating this little pop for this little, that little span in time, this little moment to be able to allow you to grip and pass over your head. And that can happen a number of ways. If it's violent enough to where it's here, maybe you can strike or go over. Sometimes it may be crunching under you, so you can shove and come back under, right?
One key detail here is to, we always say like meet in the middle, because I can try to do this and then try to duck under everything. I'm gonna have to travel so much further than if I did this and kind of did met in the middle, like right at the same time, right? Even when I'm passing, I don't wanna just do this and then try to bring his arm all the way over my head while I'm staying tall, or I don't wanna just try to go underneath it. I'm gonna go down as this goes up.
Right.
That way it allows me to clear it, and also I don't lose any of my forward force.
And so a lot of things can happen even in that little instance, right? So anything from the whole being able to actually shove your opponent back, give yourself that space, or allow, if they're crushing in on you, maybe it's to shove yourself back, right? To give yourself that space so that you can shove yourself back and catapult forward. Sometimes it's even just a slip, right? He's crushing and you're just slipping. You're creating that, like that brace for him to lean upon.
Yeah, and it's that's martial arts or anything combat related is a game about creating space or taking away space, right? And on your own terms. So if I want to create space from here, either if he's bigger than me, I gotta create space backwards. If I'm bigger than him, I'm creating space forward. And his goal is try to take away space and collapse my structure, right? So even as he leans into me, this frame that I have here is not as strong anymore. So that's why having these movements where you're having your body weight behind a push or having your body weight behind a frame, it kind of like rounds out your body, your anatomical structure, so that you can hold the guy up, right? So if I'm collapsed here and I create this frame, now when he tries to push back into me, I have time and I have space to do what I need to do, right? So let's try to add some strikes into these things. Because most of our comments are about karate is not just grappling or whatever.
All right, yeah. And we forgot. There's no strike, any strike, any karate.
So if you can imagine, these can be strikes.
Yeah.
I see it a lot in sumo, and also I've seen it a couple times in the UFC, where like you're trying to take me down here. Instead of trying to push your head away, they actually like frame the neck and just start pushing the neck away.
Yeah.
It's like getting like an animal off you. Right? They don't want their neck to be choked.
Right.
So even as I'm shucking here, this shuck should, if it's intentional or if it's in a combative sense, should be like right there. And you see that a lot in kata too. Kisanku dai, kisanku, kino yonda. The hands are close together. Even these, right? Because if I do stuff like that, you know, shucking down. The hands are together for a reason. And then also that down and up motion, usually when you're digging into a body, you want to go into it at an angle. So like you could talk about this, like hitting down onto something or hitting up into something.
Yeah, it's more advantageous to you to have like a gravity kind of help you out. So aiming downwards in somebody is going to be, it's also like the direction, like if you're talking to like about like, you know, just like the physics, if I'm trying to meet a force this way head on, it's more difficult, right? It's force meets force. But if I'm actually coming in down here, I'm aiming at like areas where he's gonna collapse, right? So it makes for better impact, right? That's why sometimes you see people will kick downwards, right? Instead of just kicking here, they actually kick downwards into you to try to help you collapse your opponent. And that works out a lot better if you can manage to do that, right? So even in these situations where you're kind of like trying to shuck somebody off of you and stuff like that, you don't want to necessarily just be pushing here, right? It's here, right, into the hip area, kind of a deal, you know, where there's joints and that helps push them back. You know, that's where we have these kind of movements and stuff like that also.
And then even going up, if someone gets knocked off balance upward, they tend to stumble, right? Stumble back on their heels. So if you're able to like push them back like that, that's gonna get a center off gravity, off balance, and you're gonna be able to overwhelm them pretty quickly.
And I guess like the whole like striking component is gonna be any one of those things you can strike to either initiate it or make it work for you, right? So it's not, I guess like we focus on a lot of the stuff that people don't necessarily focus on. That's why we kind of leave, we don't really mention the strike. But yeah, anywhere from here, when I'm breaking, if I'm trying to do this and he's just collapsing on me, if I make this space, then I can pop and then go, right? Like, or if I'm here, I can pop and then go, right? Kind of a deal. So,
and even movements that don't look like strikes, right? Like your whole passive hand thing. Because right? These can always be rakes, and these can always be rakes, and this can always be a rake. Because we've done this drill before when you just keep your hands closed and try to move things around. If I'm just keeping my hands closed and just moving things around, these become knuckles, right?
Yeah, they're like you're clubbing.
Right.
Everything is clubbing something. So the whole act of doing this thing, it's boom, back, back, back. Right, everything's smacking. And that's the other thing is like, you know, like I don't have to be just worried here, right? Even if Michael's putting up a guard for me, like coming in knuckling somebody hard here, like he can put his hand up there, it's something to hurt. It's gonna make him drop his arm, right? Kind of a deal. So you just have to keep that stuff in mind, like everything's a target, right? Whenever you're doing stuff. So here, this is a target right there, right? Sorry.
Ow.
Right, this is a target, right? Everything's a target, so I don't have to just be focused on like, well, let me get to his leg. I mean, closest thing is here, so me going boom, just to hit him in the arm, just to cause that kind of reaction, and then I'm there again, right? So yeah, it just kind of, everything kind of depends on the situation. But I think like, we like this drill because, you know, I play football in junior high and high school and stuff like that, and you do all these drills, and then you see them like, you know, when you watch tape and stuff like that, it just makes sense, you know, like anytime like you're doing that kind of frame, even in jiu-jitsu, you're coming up off the ground, off your knee, and you're having to create that frame to create space and then blow past somebody. It's the same kind of like work that you're doing. It's the same physics, same principles you're applying, right? So
word.
Word.